أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وأوحينا إلى أم موسى أن أرضعيه فإذا خفت عليه فألقيه في اليم ولا تخافي ولا تحزني إنا رادوه إليك وجاعلوه من المرسلين فالتقطه آل فرعون ليكون لهم عدوا وحزنا إن فرعون وهامان وجنودهما كانوا خاطئين صدق الله العظيم عندي سوريكم آيات في القرآن الكريم الله سبحانه وتعالى has given us some beautiful lessons of iman that make us understand and realize how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala controls everything in this universe and nothing can happen in this world without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Many times we see things totally opposite than what the reality is. It's because of our limited understanding, because of our limited vision. We can't see behind certain points. Our brain, our mind, our eyes, our hearing, everything is very and extremely limited to stop at certain points. Beyond that, it does not work. It cannot work. And the only source of knowledge beyond that is what we get from Rabbul Alameen subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ilm that came to us from رب العالمين through أنبياء عليهم الصلاة والسلام. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم once he was going somewhere and he sees a young boy who is about 11 years old or less than that. Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله عنه. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called the boy and he gave him a ride with him. So the boy now is sitting behind Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam takes the opportunity to teach him some lesson of iman. Lesson of trust in Rabbul Alameen subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you can say this hadith that I'm about to read. It's Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's instruction and advice to the children of the ummah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says to Abdullah ibn Abbas, this young boy, Ya Bunay, O my son, احفظ الله يحفظ. Always protect the orders of Allah, Allah will protect you. Always protect the orders of Allah, Allah will protect you. You neglect the orders of Allah, Allah will ignore you. Today when me and you we feel that by following the order of Allah, we may get into a hardship, into a difficulty. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is teaching even to the children of the Ummah that from your childhood you need to remember this lesson, تَحْفَظِ اللَّهَ يَحْفَظْكَ. If you always protect Allah, protect the orders of Allah, Allah will protect you. تَحْفَظِ اللَّهَ تَجِدْهُ تُجَاهِ. When you protect the orders of Allah, you would find Allah's help toward you. You would find Allah's mercy, His rahmah showering on you. Allah will turn towards you. And Allah will turn towards you simply means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open the doors of His mercy for you. Then he goes on to say, إِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَسْأَلِ اللَّهِ. Remember, whenever you need to ask for something, ask Allah. إِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَسْأَلِ اللَّهِ. Whenever you need to ask for something, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to develop the habit within us as parents and teach our children the same lesson. That before we ask anyone for anything in this world, first and turn to Allah and ask Rabbul Alameen subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hearts are in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Situations are in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything in this world is controlled by Rabbul Alameen subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tomorrow I'm going to go take my family for Hajj. And the person is so confident that he's going tomorrow. I have my car. I took my car for a service and it's all set and ready. Night before even he goes to bed, he goes and fills the gas in the car. All the stuff that they have to load in the car, everything is in there. Everything is set. In the morning, he can't find the key. I remember once a brother, he came in a car and he goes, a very expensive car. Believe me, this is outside of the masjid. He comes to the masjid and we told him, stay for lunch. No, I have to go. I have to leave. You know, he came from far, he said, you know, spend a little time, and tell him that he doesn't know what happened, he's down in hurry. He goes out, he can't find his feet. So subhanAllah, he looks here and there, and then he finds his feet. Now he's trying to open the door. This is one of the most expensive cars, really. And he tries to open the door, and the key doesn't work. And he's crying and crying and crying. Almost half an hour, he's doing his best, but it has to work. It works all the time. I had this car for 6 months. It has to work. But the key doesn't work. Call AAA. Okay, go away. I said, we can open the door for you, but we can't make the key work for you. The person is stuck. If the time is gone, the only dealer is going to fix this thing. It's Sunday. Dealing to the source. Amazing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows us that don't depend on your abilities and on your own preparation. إِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَاسْأَلِ اللَّهِ. Whenever you need to ask something, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many times you find out, I'm just ready, I'm going to do it. Never achieve it. You're going somewhere. You even left your home, you're on the way. It's not a phone call, you have to go back. And you see those situations. Being money is nothing new. But we don't learn our lesson from it that is after the altar for standing love. Before you call someone, I need some help from you.
And then someone helps me. Can we do this? First thing they grab. Ya Allah, I'm starting it. Make it easy for me. Ya Allah, I'm doing it. Help me finish this.
إِذَا سَأَلْتَكَ سَأَلْ مَا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم says in a hadith لِيَسْأَلْ أَحَدَكُمْ رَبُّهُ. Every person should get into the habit of asking Allah, even to the extent that when you run out of salt in your house and you know you can buy salt everywhere, you can run to the corner store, you can go to the neighbor's door, not in what house, and in fact you have a lot of relatives around you, you can just call them and tell them, you know, I need a salt, so inshallah I'm coming to pick it up. They'll give it to you. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, before you leave, before you start doing any of those arrangements, first thing make dua to Allah, ya Allah, I ran out of salt, I need some salt in my home, and then you send me to your arrangements. It's a habit of always making dua. And we find ourselves, we're always in need. We need something. It's only the thing that I can do and that I is destroying us. It's really destroying our connection with our Rabb subhanahu wa ta'ala that I feel I can do. So I'll call him one when I find myself totally stuck and I can't do it. I didn't realize that all the other work that was done and Allah allowed me to do it, it was from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. It wasn't my ability and it wasn't my power and my commitment or anything that I have in this world that I use, the means that I'm using, there and there, nothing. Sometimes the very same means that we use to get a benefit out of it, it turns against us. The very same thing. A person got a good business. Now he has to go overseas. He's really good. Yeah, keep on traveling for his business. And very proudly told people, you know, my business has expanded so much and I have to travel every week. He doesn't know it's maybe that the angel of death is calling him somewhere else. He feels I'm going for a business trip. But he doesn't know he's going on a death trip. The angel of death was waiting for him and he won't go over there unless he would go have that business extending and he had to travel to that part of the world. And he would go over there and give his ruh to the angel of death over there. Only last week, I was out of town. And a brother came to me. He said, I'm going with a funeral. And then he explained the situation of the funeral. He said, we're taking funeral back home. Regardless of the rules of the Sharia about taking that janazah back home and wherever he was taken, he said, this person came 4 years old. He applied for immigration to this part of the world. And they refused him. He was a friend of the ambassador in the American consulate. The ambassador came to visit him in his home for something, and he asked him, what happened about your application? He said, it was refused. Oh, he says, don't worry, I'll get it for you. So he went, and he got him the approval for his immigration here. He came over here, settled his business, applied for his wife's immigration, and got the approval. Now, next day, his flight is to go and bring his wife. He had a flight the next day to go and bring his wife. This night, he's going from his business to his home, had a car accident on the way, and he died. He got the immigration to come and meet the angel of death over here. This is where it was destined for him. It was refused. There was no way he can get it. And it comes to his door. They come and knock at his door. Do you want to take it? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted him to come here. He had to come here. Because this was the place that was destined for him. إِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَسَلَّا. We don't know. We depend on our abilities and our means. Many times we feel that I know what I'm doing.
I know I can do it. It reminds me, when we were children, we heard this from our parents and our teachers. A person wanted to go and buy a horse. And on the way he meets a friend who asked him, where are you going? He says, I'm going to buy a horse for my friend. He says, say inshallah, this is what you mean say inshallah. I know that there are so many horses being sold on the market over there. I have my money. And I can go and buy it. I'm right there now. What inshallah is very different? Say inshallah, Allah will help me. He says, I don't need it. He goes over there, started looking for the right horse. By the time he found the horse and he puts his hand in the pocket, you see the money was gone. The money was gone. He goes back, the friend standing there doing his work. He said, what happened? He says, you know, I was going to buy a horse, inshallah. And over there I found the right horse, inshallah. And then my money was stolen, inshallah. He says, I told you to take once at that time. And he refused to take. Now you're saying it three times and it's all not going to help you anymore. And I said, it's gone. The money is gone. We depend on our ability. إِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَسْأَلِ اللَّهِ All my son, whenever you ask, first thing, ask Allah. We need to train our children also the same way. I need this. Okay, make dua, and then I will give it to you inshallah. But make dua. Did you pray to Allah? Did you make dua to Allah? إِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَسْأَلِ اللَّهِ وَإِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَسْأَلِ اللَّهِ Whenever you need any help, first thing, ask the help of Allah. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ وَإِذَا اسْتَعَنْتَ فَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ Whenever you need any help, first thing turn to Allah for help. And then use the worldly means that you have to use. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم then he says to Abdullah ibn Abbas again boy وَعَلَمْ أَنَّ الْأُمَّةِ لَوْ سَمَعُوا عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَنْفَعُوكَ بِشَيْءٍ لَنْ يَنْفَعُوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ Keep in mind, and always remember, if the whole world will get together to benefit you, they won't be able to benefit you, except if Allah has predestined that for you. وَإِنْ سَمَعُوا عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَضُرُّوكَ لَنْ يَضُرُّوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ If the whole world gets together to hurt you and to harm you, they won't be able to cause you any harm if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not allow them to do it. Iman. This is our aqidah, this is our iman. But we need to build that trust in Rabbul Alameen subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was giving them the lesson of iman and aqidah. Always advising them of it.